Space Force. This new branch of the US military, although still in its infancy, already received a $15 billion request for the year 2021 from the president. And now it looks almost like a done deal that it will be SpaceX and not Boeing to first launch astronauts to the ISS. And we now even have a preliminary launch date.
Over at Artemis, the SLS Center Core is being prepared at Stennis Space Center for the first green run test. And the Trump administration wants a 12.5% increase in NASA's budget for 2021 in order to really make a crewed moon landing happen by 2024. But will that be enough? And can this request actually pass Congress? And how will SpaceX react to these developments? Will they try to land Starship on the moon before NASA? And horizontally? Let's try to find out.
The year is 2020. America is under threat. It is a dark time for the once proud nation of America. Since the cancellation of the Apollo program, this proud nation has been on a downward slope in human spaceflight. Once able to reach the moon, it now can't even reach low Earth orbit without the help of their enemies, turned friends, turned enemies again. The evil Russians under the evil Emperor Vladimir Putin. Putin himself has ordered Roscosmos to ask insanely high prices from the Americans to ferry their astronauts to the space station. A once proud nation humiliated, having to pay their adversaries in order to even be able to reach low Earth orbit. And our new, even more powerful enemy arises in the east, threatening to dominate space even more with giant new rockets and a strong military capability. America is besieged, surrounded by enemies. The days are grim for this proud nation. But lo and behold, America, under its new patriotic leadership, has created a new power of incredible might and military prowess to turn the balance once again in favor of our heroic nation. Behold the Space Force! With courage, valor, and strength of mind, the proud men and women of Space Force are set out on this noble mission to end this dark menace that threatens our beloved cradle of freedom and democracy, and to once and for all restore the uncontested supremacy of America in space with a new $15 billion budget request ordered by the president himself. For freedom! For democracy! For America!
Sorry, but this Space Force stuff is every time such an invitation. We cannot resist it! So yes, the budget request for the new Space Force for the year 2021 has been revealed last week, and it is surprisingly large. So let's analyze it, shall we? Of the $15.4 billion for this new sixth branch of the US military, which was just created in December 2019, we can see that by far the biggest part, $10.3 billion, is for research, development, test and evaluation. $2.4 billion are for procurement, $2.5 billion for operations and maintenance, and $0.1 billion for overseas contingency operations.
Now, of course, the interesting question. For what will the $10.3 billion in research and development be spent? Certainly not for Boeing, because they dropped out of the military space plane program just a few weeks ago. So which vehicle or vessel could Space Force use in the future? Well, we know one which could offer some insane capabilities. One that could transport hundreds of space marines to any place on Earth within 30 minutes. One that would enable the colonial marines. Let's be realistic, they will be called colonial marines. To reach future colonies on the moon in 2 days. And to reach future colonies on Mars in, okay, not so impressive 6 months. And also only every 2 years. But hey, at least they will be able to reach far away destinations with this device. This is just our theory, but it would make strategic sense. What if a significant portion of this $10.3 billion would flow into a special version of a Space Force Starship? How insane would that be? This is for sure some highly interesting food for thought. But of course, it first remains speculation until we see how the Space Force will develop in the next years and how much budget this new branch of the US Armed Forces will really get in 2021 and beyond. Now, while we all know that even without a boost from Space Force, SpaceX will continue building Starship and will have the necessary capital to do so thanks to the insane growth of their revenue. It's nice to see the Starship production is now being transformed to mass production from the beginning. The shots from Boca Chica clearly show that parts for Starship are being now mass produced in order to achieve the same level of efficiency and price decrease as in a Tesla Gigafactory. So in general, things are looking extremely good for SpaceX. Not only is Starship progressing nicely, but now it really seems like a done deal that it will be SpaceX to launch astronauts to the ISS. The first time from US soil for almost 10 years. Not Boeing. After we talked in last week's space episode, which you can by the way watch right here, about the fact that Starliner has some quite severe issues and is now under scrutiny from NASA and will remain grounded for quite a while. SpaceX's Crew Dragon, on the other hand, has now just arrived at Kennedy Space Center. We even have a preliminary launch date for the Dragon Daemon 2 mission, which will be the first crewed flight to the ISS with Crew Dragon, namely the 7th of May. It's basically only paperwork which remains to be done now. So now we have to wait, and hopefully it will be indeed the 7th of May until we can witness this historical moment. But it's looking very good for May or June at the latest. It's SpaceX, a private company, who is restoring America's capability to fly into space. We should really keep in mind how historic this will be.
So what is NASA actually up to these days? Well, first of all, of course, we have to talk about the upcoming green run tests of the SLS Center Core at Stennis Space Center. The SLS Center Core arrived there on January 22nd and will undergo a series of these so-called green run tests over the next few months, meaning the engines will be ignited to test if they work as expected. This here, by the way, will be the same SLS core which will be used on the Artemis 1 mission that, of course, what a surprise, has now been postponed to early 2021. But still, at least NASA is doing something on the SLS. Now, in order to get the moon program really going, the president proposed an increase of the NASA budget for the fiscal year 2021 by an incredible 12.5% to $25 billion. Now, this is quite an amazing development, we have to say. 12.5%! It would be really the first time since the 80s and early 90s that we would see an increase of this magnitude in the NASA budget. However, please don't forget that this is still only a budget request, so it has to be, of course, approved by US Congress in order to become a reality. So let's take a look at this budget request for the year 2021 and for the budget requests of the following years up until 2025. Now, first of all, we can already see how massively boosted the NASA budget would be. From $21.5 and $22.6 billion for 2019 and 2020 respectively, up to $25.2 billion in 2021, and then even more, with a maximum of $28.6 billion in 2024, the year of the first planned crewed Artemis moon landing. We see that science would face some cuts, with astrophysics most of all, and STEM engagement would be cut altogether. Now, deep space exploration systems would be gradually increased from currently $6 billion up to a maximum of $11.6 billion in 2023. With deep space exploration systems, they of course mean the hardware necessary for the moon landing. This means SLS, Orion, the Lunar Gateway, the Gateway to Mars, of course, as it's now being called, and the crewed moon lander. Now, the crewed moon lander, which currently doesn't even exist in the NASA budget, will get $3.37 billion starting in 2021. This is extremely significant, and it will be a moon lander built by a private company. Now, of course, it would be the most logical course of action for this moon lander here to be awarded, but we highly doubt it, since that so-called moon lander is a lot bigger than the entire lunar gateway, I mean bigger than the entire gateway to Mars. So the whole lunar gateway or gateway to Mars would be completely obsolete with Starship as a moon lander.
Therefore, we think that another private company will be awarded a large chunk of this $3.37 billion in order to develop a human-rated moon lander for the Artemis 3 and later Artemis missions. It might be Blue Origin. They could build a moon lander based on their Blue Moon lander, which they revealed last year in May. If NASA should really award a private company other than SpaceX to build their human-rated moon lander, SpaceX will certainly be incentivized to show NASA who is the boss. So this will lead, in our opinion, to an insane race between NASA's SLS, Orion, Gateway, and crewed lander approach versus Starship. Elon will certainly want to land Starship on the moon before NASA, just to show them how it's done. And in order to prove that Starship is a much simpler, more direct, more efficient, and also much cheaper way to get astronauts to the moon and back, this year, ladies and gentlemen, might really be the start of a wonderful new moon race. And should NASA really choose Blue Origin to build their moon lander, Elon will say,
"Challenge accepted."
And this might even be beneficial for humanity, since it will accelerate the building of our first moon base. SpaceX can land dozens of astronauts and many, many tons of cargo onto the surface of the moon per Starship, while the Blue Origin moon lander can only land a maximum of 2, maybe 3 astronauts and only a few tons of cargo onto the moon. Therefore, we actually secretly hope that NASA will award Blue Origin to build their human-rated moon lander, just to awaken the wrath of the sleeping giant SpaceX, which will then feel the challenge, and as a consequence, do a private crewed mission to the moon just a few months before NASA. So that by the end of the 2020s, we will see a huge private SpaceX moon base, while NASA will then have to ask SpaceX for permission to use their moon base. In any case, this new budget request for NASA is a really good development, and we should give Trump some credit for that. Even if you hate Trump, at least he is doing some good for space exploration. You have to admit that.
Now, over the fiscal year 2021 to 2025 time period, a total of $71 billion would be allocated for the Artemis program, including $21.26 billion for human landing systems. NASA Deputy Administrator Jim Moorhart said that the cost of putting astronauts back on the moon by 2024 is $35 billion. So with this new budget request for 2021 and the following years, it would actually be doable. Now let's collectively pray to a god of your choosing that this request will actually pass Congress, please! Now we have to admit we don't have a good feeling for how high the chances for this request are to actually pass Congress. Maybe some of our dear American viewers who have more insight into the inner workings of Congress would be so friendly to let us know what they think the chances are for this request to actually pass Congress. Some senators, such as Democratic Representative Kendra Horn from Oklahoma, were, of course, what a surprise, immediately displeased with this budget request. But we sincerely hope that reason and logic will prevail this time, because this increased NASA budget would really ensure that we'll get to the moon in the next few years, maybe even with two separate approaches, with SpaceX's Starship and with the cumbersome and old-school SLS Orion Gateway lunar lander architecture.
No matter who lands first or how, we are excited in any case. By the way, a quick remark, since many people say that a behemoth Starship wouldn't be able to land on the moon because the Raptor engines would be too powerful and hurl the lunar soil away at too high speeds, and the fine dusty lunar soil called regolith is not stable enough for Starship. there are actually rumors going around that Starship would actually land on the moon horizontally using some powerful cold gas thrusters. So we could see a specially adapted horizontally landing Starship with more powerful cold gas thrusters for crewed moon landings. Takeoff would of course also happen horizontally using the same cold gas thrusters. Highly interesting food for thought, ladies and gentlemen.
So what do you say to this amazing NASA budget request for 2021? This is a very good development, right? And what do you, especially you dear American viewers, think that this will actually pass Congress?
And where do you think that $10 billion for research and development for Space Force will be spent on? A colonial marine version of Starship?
I hope it will be called USS Sulaco.
And if you have liked our show, be sure to give it a like and maybe even share it with your friends. That would really help this channel to grow.
So then, see you in our next video.
Bye!